So we will now start our Venus meditation. We will start with opening up ourselves, all our energy centers. We will start from the feet and then create a channel upwards through our bodies so we can absorb all energy around us. So start by opening the chakras in your toes, the middle of your foot, then your heel. And open up the chakras just below your kneecaps. On top of your kneecaps. Open up your first chakra at the base of your spine. Feel how now your legs are welcoming the vibrations of the earth to flow into your legs and into your pelvic area. The earth, the body, is waiting for the other energies, ready to receive them. Feel that you want to be like the earth, a fertile, soft, black earth, where many things can grow and thrive. Feel this power of fertility rising up to your second chakra. Where fertility from being passive becomes active. Instead of allowing things to happen to you, you start wanting things to happen to you, to come into your life. It becomes an active invitation rather than a passive enduring. And open up your second chakra more. Feel that as the second chakra becomes more open, so your life force starts to become more active. Then open up your third chakra, your stomach. Feel how your body gets ready to move along with its environment, to be inspired, to create, to sing, to dance, to make love, to do things in a joint fashion, to unite itself, to harmonize itself through its action. Feel if you are getting enough of this. Are you joining and playing enough with the beings around you? Or are you doing your own thing and they're doing their own thing? Try to find the harmony which is possible in action. Try to see your whole life as a dance. Feel the dance of the energies around you, the dance of the earth. open up the heart. This can be tricky, because for many people the heart is one of the most damaged chakras, hurt by betrayal, by disappointment, miscommunication. It is through the heart that our spirit can connect to other spirits, that can listen and experience the world. So we need the heart to be open for everything which happens. Without the heart, it's merely happening on the material level. Will pass by without leaving a trace on our spirits. As the heart opens, we become receptive, not just to the physical world, but also to the world of spirit, to the world of experience, feelings and emotion. They move us, they drive us. They determine how we react, how we see the world. Feel that the world is inviting you. See it from a myriad of perspectives. It wants to swirl you and twirl you around and around. So ultimately, from all the little facets, you can gain a better view, a greater understanding, greater sympathy. Start opening your hand chakra, your fingertips, the palm of the hand, the base of the hand. Once they are open, also open your elbow chakra. And as your arms get more active, also open the throat chakra. So that you can become one, not just with the people in society, but with society itself. You can feel the religions, the ideals, the culture moving about you. You're part of one or several of these. And all of these things, all these races, are also caught in a dance together. You are dancing with them, swirled along with them. This is always so. It's just now that you're starting to realize it and experience it more clearly through the powers of Venus. Realize that you are just a vessel for the powers of your race, of your culture, of your religion. By working with the power of Venus, you can become a better vessel. You can become a knight, a champion, a priestess. Of your people, your religion, your culture, your tradition. And you can help that whole group to unite, to harmonize, to grow, to evolve through you. In the same way as the group imprints itself upon you, the group itself is a resultant of all its members. And every culture or religion is continuously renewing itself through flowing into the people and flowing back out of the people. You are part of this circulation, of the breath of culture, of the breath of religion. So all these powers move into you and manifest themselves through you out again into the collective. Open up yourself now in your forehead, the sixth chakra, the third eye. Feel that you are connected to what can be called the collective consciousness. Or the collective subconsciousness, humanity, the spirit of humanity, the Akasha Chronicles, your ancestors, past lives, all the facets of your being are connected to the third eye. It's the doorway to your own universe, to your own story. And all the things in your story are there to teach you, to guide you. But you have to be willing to listen, to open up to them, to surrender to them. Allow the power of Venus to descend into your brain. And decipher all the dreams, all the omens, all the symbols which are around you. To know which impulse is trying to guide you. What is merely background or distraction. Only your third eye can tell you this. What is the true light? What is the false light? By thinking you will not know. But by the blessings of Venus, your mind can become clear. The fog can disappear. If you have the courage to face the truth. And there is nothing to fear, because you are eternal. More eternal than the human race itself. Feel the energy moving through your third eye. As the cosmos starts to reveal itself through you in visions, in dreams, in memories and thoughts. Your brain is just a screen which the entirety of your past lives and the cosmos is projecting itself on. Your thoughts are not reality, but they are reflections of reality. To allow those projections to come into focus with where you are now, with what you are now, so the images can provide you with guidance and understanding, not just of yourself, but also of all other people, all other beings which are a part of your life. Understand what role you're playing for each other, how you are trying to teach each other, help each other, heal each other. And finally, open your crown chakra on the top of your head. Allow the cosmos and the higher beings to co-inhabit your body with you. Allow the Holy Spirit to gain communion with your spirit. Feel the divine power, its light and its fire descends into your body to cleanse it, to purify it, to ignite your own inner light, your own inner flame, which can guide you through your life. These are the blessings of Venus, which we can partake from in this meditation. Take as long as you want to remain in this state, finding yourself a part of a greater whole, feeling once more the reason for your existence, the reason for your form and action. Thank you, Venus, for opening us and welcoming us into your bosom, the bosom of the cosmos, of the universe.